In this screencast, I'm going to give you a little tour of how I use Google Calendar. I shall say up front that I use only a fraction of the tools and features of this terrific application, but it is, this is how I use it. So this is my current month, the gray date here, today's date. You can navigate in a variety of ways. You can, over here on the left, you can jump back month at a time, May, April, and let's come back to, you can look at this in a week at a time, you can see it a day at a time, 4 days if you like to really slice your day up. There's an agenda view that lets you just see the events, but I tend to think in terms of months, so I like the month view. You can have multiple calendars, but again, I'm not going to get into all that. I'm going to pretty much limit this for the sake of time to how I use it. Let's pick a date here on June 9th. You'll see that there was only room for four or five entries here, but it lets you know that there are additional entries. Anytime I spend some money, so here I paid an internet bill, bought some gas, paid a Visa bill. I tagged that with a color green for money and just a little visual cue, so it helps me go back and look, because I'll track when I paid a bill, and the little color key helps with that. I'll come back to reminders in a moment. I've got a haircut schedule for next week, so let me enter that item here so you can see kind of how I use that. You can enter an event, which I'm going to do here, or a reminder. Like I said, I'll come back to that. So I know that my haircut is going to be at 3:15 p.m. Google is very forgiving, too, with the format. You can enter this just about any way. 3 p.m. haircut. And now if I click on that and edit the event, you see that I can do all kinds of stuff here. I mean, I could have made this an all-day event, and there are times where that's handy. You can make it a repeating event. I rarely use that feature, so I'm not going to talk about it. But this information below is handy. So where, I'm going to put in La Cien, and it remembers from my previous entries. This is the La Cien Salon and Day Spa. Yes, that's where I get my hair cut. And I can add a brief description. See Lisa. I can put in a notification. I can either get an email notification or just a push notification. And it tells me, you know, here I can control when I get it. The available busy stuff, who can see my calendar? Again, these are features that I don't use, so I'm not going to go into them. But I do add attachments frequently. So in this case, I took a photo of a previous haircut, as you can see here, and I've got that in Google Docs, and I want to attach that to this event. So that gives me a quick reference to that file without me having to go hunt for it. Okay, let's go back and look at a couple of others. So I'm going to do one more. Worldwide Developers Conference. I watched that with my friend George on Monday the 13th. I want to add the video of the Worldwide Developer Conference. So I'm going over to YouTube, and I'm going to grab the link to this. I'm going to come back to Calendar. I'm going to edit that, and I'm going to add an attachment. Well, actually, in this case, I'm not going to add an attachment. But in the description, I'm going to put the link to that YouTube. So now, without having to go hunt for that YouTube video, I can go back to this date, pull that up, and quickly have that bit of information. All right. Let's go back to February 24th. What did I have on February 24th? Oh, had a treadmill delivered. And if I edit that event, you can see here that I've added a couple of items. I've got a invoice, again in Google Docs, for the treadmill. And I think I did one on, let's go to March 17th. And February, March 17th. At 2 o'clock, I bought a new battery for my Mini Cooper, and I attached a link to Google Calendar of that invoice. So just a quick, easy way to be able to find that kind of stuff. Let's go back to reminders. And down here on today's date, you says I've got three reminders scheduled. If I open those up, you can see those reminders and I can edit them. I can check them off as having completed them. And once they're completed, they stay at the date and time they were completed. So on the 9th, I paid a couple of bills and I've got that reminder completed. Let's see what else would be useful. You know, one last thing. I'm going to go into the settings here and go to the labs. I turn this on and off from time to time. This is a little plugin or a little tool called Jump to Date. And I'm going to enable that. Hit save. And now on the right side over here, you'll see that I've got a little Jump to Date tool. Now for most folks, you start using Google Calendar and you don't worry about any dates prior to that. But I had 20 years of day timers with some dates that I wanted to remember. So I wanted to be able to go back to 1984 or lots of dates and enter items before Google Calendar even existed. So let's, I'm gonna go back, I'm gonna give you an example here. Let's jump back to 1984. And let's jump back to May, and I click Jump to Date. You'll see that I've got a couple of entries in here. So on the 15th, a letter from Clyde Lear at 9 a.m. If I edit that, and you see I've attached a PDF of that letter from way back. This was a memo, an internal memo at the company that announcing that I had been hired for a new position. So let's see, let's jump to 1994, see if anything's going on. So again, these were various things that were happening. I attended Comdex in Atlanta, Georgia. Anybody remember Comdex? All right, that is, that's enough. Let's jump back to today. Let's see, is there anything else before we wrap this up? I'm not going to get into how this works with the iOS app, but they obviously work nicely together. Google Calendar is one of my most useful, important tools.